All right. I'd have to ditch them.
the Sun King!
The wrong side.
I need a word with you, Nora.
Can't carry more.
Sorry to bother, but could we talk? May I have your attention just for a moment? Please stop, just for a moment. You gave me a second chance at life. Thank you.
You're okay.
Byvan, over.
It's better to wait. Dust Mesa. Now I need to find some place too high to reach, if I'm to believe anything Finland said. What do you know? And it's empty.
Spear girl!
Of course.
You found it. The perfect location for an ambush. Now throw down that magnificent spear, and we'll let you live.
You've obviously heard of me. You know what I'm capable of. Why do you think this will turn out well for you?
I like the odds. Get her!
Why do I bother? To the Meridian docks, I'll bet. Thank you, Petra. I'll let you finish up.
Honest metalwork is hardly work at all. Look after yourself, Flamehair.
Have you just polished that armor, was it?
Of course.
Isn't that a little...
What?
Nothing.
Out with the woman. See that sunrise.
Oh no. Let me in! By fire and spit! Let me in!
So
Sun King of Odd Spies saved Prince Itamen from the Shadow Cult.
Oh, Fernand. Our deal is off.
Oh, it's you. How about a new deal? You could just cut off my finger, or my hand, or my left arm, but that's my final offer.
Tempting, but I want you to spread the word to all your crooked friends. Me and my spear are off limits from now on.
I can do that. What should I tell them?
Tell them how you barely escaped with your life. Get creative. You're good at that. I don't want to have to come find you again.
Understood. You won't hear from any of us ever again.
I'd better not.
How did he get so close to the Sun King?
I have no problem with Talana Khan Padish as head of the Hunter's Lodge. She's the last of her house.
Are you Gleave, the healer?
I had planned to spend the day gazing at the lands of my exile and feeling sorry for myself, but you're not from Sunfall, so this could be interesting.
I came from the Tenth City there. There's a sick girl. Her brother told me about you.
The answer is no.
What?
No, I can't spare the medicine, nor my time to administer it. My resources are already spread thin, thin as the soiled cloths I have to use for dressings.
Why won't you help?
Look at it from my perspective. What meager goods I can get must be smuggled in. That's expensive. The behemoth's share goes to the military. Of course, there are the demands of the Citadel. Helis's kestrels are so prone to sticky ends. What's left, that's for the nobles, who can pay well for my services.
Look at it from my perspective. A little girl is sick.
I think we are calling to each other across an ideological impasse.
What's stopping me from just making you do it?
I'd have to cause a situation. And you wouldn't harm the only healer disgraced enough to work for the Shadow Carja, would you?
Well, we've only just met, but yes, it's tempting.
And take it up with the Citadel. They decide who lives and dies. Nothing you can do would compare to my punishment if I use the last of my stock on a tent girl.
You're kind of an ass, healer.
There's no cure for a conscience. But in this line of work, I've built up an immunity to it. And yet, if you feel so strongly about this one girl, perhaps we can make a deal. My charity for a Thunderjaw heart.
That's not how charity works.
It is how deals work. You'd settle my debts. For a while.
I already have the part.
Wow! We could already have a deal. Quickly now, let's salve your poor conscience.
See to the girl, and it's yours. Not before.
Oh, please. On my oath, this girl will survive to see our sad future. You and I shouldn't be seen together. Go on to the slums ahead of me. I'll find you presently. You do stand out in the crowd.
It's you. Hello again.
I've brought someone to see your sister.
How did you... What did we do to deserve... No, wait. I don't even want to ask, in case a shadow passes over and it's gone.
Smart boy.
She'll have his full attention, won't she?
Once I'm freed of other distractions, yes. That's enough excitement for my rest day.
Thank you, again, for giving her a better chance.
What's she called?
Shiana.
I knew a Shiana once. She sang in a tavern. How is your sister's singing voice?
She likes ball games. She wants to be a soldier.
That's a shame.
Stocking up. And one of these. No space.
Day 12. As we watch the booster arc up into the night sky, riding a pillar of flame, you took my hand, squeezed it, and said, "You have written the story of our family across the stars."
Easy, easy. Might need that. Save this. Good for an old remedy.
Huh.
plan. Another message from the ancient past.
Apakashit's dormitor, day two. My father guest lectured here. A 300-level military history course on the age of human air power. Might as well have been teaching medieval siege tactics. I was 8 when he died.
Look out below! Ouch. easier when I was a kid.
Here they come.
Tricia's. every vantage a story.
Apaka Shitstorm Tour Day 4. It's hard to believe Metallurgic International used to be headquartered in this dreary old ziggurat. Why, its office was on the second floor from the top. If Emin had a policy against workplace romances, he probably wrote it.